Hi everyone and welcome to this new video. In today's project I'm going to create the Big Brother version of this fella here, which I did a couple of weeks back. And in case you have not seen this video, I will link it here in this video as well. The painting from that video was already sold to the Americas, and thank you so much Alyssa for giving this artwork a new home. I was really, really honored to see this one was loved so much and that you wanted to get it for yourself. So thank you once more. In this painting here, it is again a bit larger, so therefore it is the Big Brother version. The first one was about 30 by 60 centimeters, and this one here is 40 by 80 centimeters. So just a bit larger, but large enough to use my kitchen table again, as this is easier for you to have a look at it, and for me easier to work with. My desk is already messy. I did a couple more pours before that, which you will see of course as well at some time. And yeah, you can see what I've used here. This is the pure canvas. I again put some pinboard pins underneath it to have it elevated from the surface to allow the drip off paint to drip off. And on there you can see the little cup tool that I glued together. It is the same cup that I used for all my other ring pours so far. So since the beginning that I've introduced you to this tool. And yeah, it's just the same tool. I just let it be, and if there is paint in there from a previous pour, I just let it dry and it keeps the cups even better together. And yeah, that it's just the same tool. So if you have not seen those videos, I again link them here in the video as well, just in case you want to check out what you can make with this and improve on it if you like. So this is a good version to create ring pours, or if not rings, the effect that I was going to achieve for this one. So I wanted it to look somewhat similar, not completely the same of course, because this is something no one might be able to achieve, but somewhat similar, and I wanted to invert the colors. So in the first one, the white was the most dominant color, and in this one here, I wanted the blue to be the most dominant color, just to see how it looks in the end. And technique-wise, this is pretty much straightforward, so as you have seen me doing in my other videos as well. Before I started pouring in general, I added a layer of white paint to my canvas just to allow the paint to flow easier, which makes it easier especially for those longer canvases, because if you don't have this layer of paint where the actual pour can glide over, the paint grips to the canvas and rolls over, if you know what I mean. And so you're already losing a lot of those little fine lines from the ring pour that you're going to create by pouring itself, which is a pity. So if you have this base layer of paint where you actually pour can glide over, you don't lose as many of these initial created rings or ring lines or whatever you want to call them. So this is something I would recommend doing. If you do not want to use a base layer of paint, you can even wet the canvas itself. So just use some pure water, wet the canvas until it's really soaked, and yeah, then you can start pouring as well. This will also prevent the color to grip to the canvas that much. It will be easier to glide over, but it also creates some other effects and disadvantages at some point. So most favorite version is the base layer color version. So just test it out what you like more. And then finally, what you unfortunately cannot see in the video because I was out of the video frame, is I started pouring. The canvas itself is a bit elevated on the side that I'm pouring just to allow the paint to flow over the canvas just from itself. But basically I did not do any magic there. I just tilted this cup tool and let the paint flow out. I try not to move my hands as much as I can, so I want to be as still as I can and just let the paint flow out. Make sure to not tilt too much to not make the paint flow out too quickly. This in a way will prevent you from getting those feather ring lines. But on the opposite, if you pour too slowly, you will have very stretched lines. So find some middle way. It's always about the experimenting. So just see what works best for you, I'd say. So when everything was poured, it was time for the stretching, which is always one of the most satisfying and stressing out parts. I knew what I wanted to achieve in the look itself, so I really did not have to take care that it becomes a ring, which normally this tool was created for. So this was some stress factor relieved from my shoulders at that point, and then I just moved it around to create a somewhat look that I wanted to achieve, which I did. I was super happy at the end that it looked as I wanted it to look. It was really pretty. It was something like the inverted version of the first port that I did with the more white. And I just liked it. I really liked it. Those are my most favorite colors anyways when it comes to a color palette combination. So yeah, I was happy. This pour was not as thick, so it went rather quickly. I varnished it and then it was done. As I recently got so many requests on varnishing and versions of varnishing, I do have this video still planned, so I'm still working on it. I have a couple of versions filmed for you, but I'm still lacking one last version which I want to implement there, and once this is done, I do the voiceover and upload it here to give you all more of my knowledge and insight about the varnishing process. Many of you will already know most of the topics I crossed there, I guess. But perhaps there's something new, or perhaps there's something that you know that I don't, and you can tell me in the comments. I'm always happy about any new insights in stuff. So yeah, but as a small teaser on this project here, which I filmed the varnishing process on, which will also be implemented in the varnishing video itself, I can just show you what I did here. So this is the dried version, and as you can see, this blue again dried beautifully dark. I really love that blue. It looks very much lighter when it is red and dries super dark. So this is again my Artina brand, which I love to work with, but it is still not available in the US. So if you are in Europe, basically you can get them via Amazon, just look for Artina, but not in the US yet. But if you have the chance to get that same color perhaps, so this one is called Phthalo Cyanin Blue, just look in your stores if you can get something called similar, so it should be somewhat the same looking, and give it a try if it works as great as this color here. I really would love to have every one of you have this color. I just so much love it. Anyways, so you can see the result here, and I varnished this one with the DecoArt top coat, which I really, really love. They have sent it over to me to test it out, and I really love it. They write on it that you should apply it on the canvas and tilt it to a 45 degree angle to make it flow from the canvas to have an even coverage, which works, but it really wastes a lot of the product, which I am not so much a fan of. I have tried this in the very first attempt that I did a couple of videos back when I did the greenish pour. Yeah, I really don't like wasting products. I even scrape up my drip off paint and reuse it for base layer paint. So I did not like this concept, and I decided to make my own version, which is basically pouring the top coat medium on the artwork and using my finger paints and move it around. Of course I'm using a glove because this stuff is quite sticky. Move it around to have everything completely covered, and making sure to have enough of the medium on there to make it self-level, so to speak. So if you have too little and spread it around, it might not combine itself again to be level and stay with some smaller gaps and bumps and valleys and such. So I use enough to have it more or less self-leveled. It is not completely even, as you can see, so it still has some bumps and, yeah, you know, valley structures, but it does not really make such of a deal, because when everything is dried, it is completely flat and perfect, looks great, love this stuff. I normally use the Liquitex varnish, which I also use. It's same grade as this stuff here, but this here is a bit thicker and allows you more to play around with. The Liquitex is a bit thinner and flows more. So yeah, just see what you can get for a better price perhaps, and what you like more. So if it was for me, I really enjoy working with both mediums. Yeah, and fun fact about the color, when it is red, it is pretty light blue. When it's dry, it's really dark blue. And when you put something red over it, it's getting light blue again. So this is always a bit freaking me out when I varnish it, because the first areas where the red medium touched it gets light first, and then when you spread a medium, it has a different shade of blue, which is always freaking me out because I think I've ruined everything now. But when everything is cured and dry, everything is back to normal and back to the dark. So, oh, back to the dark. So back to the original color. And yeah, just as a small teaser, which was longer than I intended. So yeah, that's what I did here. As usual, I really hope you liked the video and the result that I got here. If you have any questions, leave me below in the comment box or some comments if you'd like. My materials are linked in the video description if you want to have a look at them, as well as my social media links if you want to get in touch with me. And not to forget my lovely Etsy store if you want to get some of my original artworks for yourself. In case you want to commission me for something, realistic painting, pour painting, geode, resin artwork, whatsoever, I would be super happy and proud if you leave me a message as well. So yeah, if you like this video, please give me a thumbs up and share with everyone that you know to help my channel grow. Subscribe to my channel if you've not done already and press the bell icon to not miss out on any of my new videos. Currently it's about 2 or 3 new videos coming this week. So yeah, that's basically everything. Thank you so much for your time, thank you for watching, and other than that, I hope to see you in my next videos. Have a great day, bye bye!